Essentially, it is a miniature brewery. And this is the first semester that the students are actually brewing on it. Super exciting to be working on this system because it really does mimic a commercial brewing system. It consists of two 50-liter brew houses and eight 50-liter fermenters and some finishing tanks for the beer.
I think it's pretty good. There's still some intact, but not.
I feel like I'm a hands-on learner, and this is exactly like what we're going to be doing when we get our big jobs, so it just gives you that experience.
We have two breweries on campus, so we have the Ramskeller Brew House and we have this research brewery here. The Ramskeller Brew Pub actually produces beer for sale over there. This beer is just for research and student projects. The facilities that we have available to us in Fermentation Science and Technology include the Gifford Brew Kitchen and Innovation Lab. There's the Quality Analytical Lab here. We have a sensory laboratory as well where we do sensory analysis on beer, and then we also have the Malt Lab.
So 79.5 then would be perfect, right? That'll drop us down to
Brewing 70. In itself is an interdisciplinary science. Many students don't realize this when they first get into it. It's not just microbiology, it's not organic chemistry, it's not just engineering, it's all of these things wrapped in together.
I think with your team I was able to reset that flow meter.
The professors love what they do and they love to teach what they do, and I think that's awesome and it makes us want to learn more.
We are unique in that we are a four-year program. There's not many of those in the country. And we don't just specialize in beer. It's food science, it's fermentation science.
Yeah, I highly recommend any student even thinking about going into this degree to check out CSU first.